Yeah, what's going on, TTC? Yeah, I'm making this video right now. Kirk Cousins just fell short of first down, and the Steelers just took over with the ball with 4 minutes and 17 seconds left, and we're losing 31-16. So this game's pretty much over now at this point. Yeah, you know, the first half we came out and we was able to move the ball, but we didn't capitalize on two situations we had in the red zone. One being was off of the first drive we had was a good drive, but we fell short trying to get the first down around at a little bit past midfield, something 40-something yard line. We opted to punt instead of go for it. Then they got the ball, and our defense was looking pretty good in the first quarter. Breland got an interception that took us down and got us in good field position. That only ended up being a field goal, though. We only got a field goal out of it. Was able to move the ball down another time, got another field goal out of it, wasn't able to cash in again. And once we was up 6-0, I knew we should have been up at least 10-0 at the worst at that point. We should have scored at least one touchdown out of those two chances we had, and we didn't. It was two field goals. And I was like, that's going to bite us later, and it ended up doing it. So, and then the Steelers started getting getting in the Florida game. And, yeah, it was just some weird stuff going on. Josh Norman had a play that looked like it was a fumble. They said it wasn't. Ew, debatable. I'm not blaming that play or nothing. I'm just, you know, could have went either way. I guess it wasn't enough to overturn it. I thought he made a football move, but, you know, whatever. That whole ruling right there, they really need to clean up that gray area, because that definitely was a gray area. You know, Ryan Kerrigan had a strip. He should have dove on the ball. We'd have been right there in the red zone. You know, first down, field goal range, possibly a touchdown. We left those points off the board because he tried to pick it up. And then Pouncey came behind, stripped him, and they ended up recovering the ball. And from that point on, it seemed like that's when the game went all Steelers after that. Antonio Brown was picking on Breland tonight. Josh Norman had a good game, but Breland had a rough game. They had two fourth down conversions in the first half that killed us. And the first one being, it was a fourth and one, and then Antonio Brown scored a touchdown on Breland. Breland looked like he went for the interception on the instant replay, but the ball went through his hands and Brown was able to catch it. He should have probably just went and tried to knock it down, because if he knocked it down, it would have been our ball, because that was fourth down. So I don't know. Then they had another touchdown in the first half where the ball did some ricochet action and just surprisingly enough ended up in the Steelers' hands. And yeah, they had a couple of things bounce their way tonight. But you leave that many points on the board, or possible points on the board, it's going to be a rough time for you. And the second half, you know, that's when they just let D'Angelo Williams loose on us. I mean, he ran all over us tonight. We could not stop that motherfucker. It was depressing watching this shit. They just dinked and dunked us. Ben dinked and dunked us to death. And, you know, he took a couple of shots downfield and they paid off for him. Antonio Brown scored on Breland again later on in the game. This one was worse than the first one, because the first one I thought Breland had good coverage. This one he just got beat. And Breland also had another touchdown scored on his watch with D'Angelo Williams. He took a bad angle and tried to arm tackle him, and he just bust through it. And it was a rough night. If you ask me who I blame this the most on, it would have to be the run defense and Kirk Cousins, who looks like he just threw another interception in the end zone to fucking Harrison. Oh, amazing. Kirk Cousins was all over the place tonight. He was inconsistent, throwing the ball behind our receivers, underthrowing the receivers, skipping the ball to them. He came out looking flat. The whole team looked flat. The whole team came out looking flat, him in particular. So, yeah, we got to do better. We got to do better. I'm not going to panic because I wouldn't have been over-enthusiastic if we won this game. I would have been happy, but I wouldn't have based our whole season on a win. So I'm not going to base this whole season off a loss. Calm down. I know you motherfuckers jumping up and down rejoicing, but it's one game. We lost the first game last year against the Dolphins, too. You know? So, let me say congratulations to Mac Main. He tried to bring that heat this week. Congratulations to him. We got to just dust ourselves off and get ready for these cow bitches, man. We got to tighten up, fix these penalty situation too, because the penalties killed us tonight. That's just what it is, man. I guess I'll holler at y'all haters later. I'm out.